your teachers and your families who have brought you here today. Well, I have a couple of pictures that I want to show you. They're both by Norman Rockwell. He was kind of a famous American painter. And he painted pictures of everyday life in the time in which he lived. They've got lots of detail, lots of faces. They're fun pictures. What do you see? What's this picture? Yes. Thanksgiving, right. As a, like maybe a grandpa and a grandma presenting the turkey and all the people gathered around the table. Can you see that? It's a great picture. Got their best china on the table, some yummy food waiting to be served. Everybody looks happy and smiling. This picture is actually from a series of paintings that he did, and this one's called Freedom from Want. I like that picture, but I have another picture that I like even better that he did. This one is called Saying Grace. Now, you know what? It might be Thanksgiving too. Can you see it? It's a diner, kind of just a little inexpensive restaurant. There's a bunch of people there. Some are kind of tough looking. A couple of guys are smoking cigarettes. But in the middle of this restaurant, there's a lady and a little boy. And they're praying. This picture is called Saying Grace. I like that one a lot. Because it reminds me that we can thank God when we have a lot. And we can also thank Him when we have a little. And that's one of the lessons from our history of Thanksgiving in this country. The very first Thanksgiving meal, I'm not sure that they have the same kinds of things that we have. What do you guys like for Thanksgiving dinner? What's your favorite thing? Turkey. How many of you like turkey? All right. What else? Anybody else? Ooh, potatoes. Cupcakes. All right. Tomatoes. Other things. Yes. Pumpkin pie. Amorous. Lots of good food. Lots of things. Do you know, before the Thanksgiving that we remember with the pilgrims and the Indians, before that Thanksgiving, where they had lots of food, they went through a time where they didn't have much food at all. In fact, their rations got so low that they just had some dry corn, and they didn't even have that much dried corn to eat. They had 5 kernels of corn a day. That's not very much food. It wasn't even popcorn. It was just corn that they kind of pounded a little bit and made into a little bit of a mush. And that was all they had. Not surprisingly, many people died of starvation. It was very sad. But in the year that followed, the pilgrims learned more about how to grow things here. Some of the friendly Indians helped them, and the next year, they had a good harvest, and they looked forward to having a winter in which they would all have enough to eat. In some families, there's a tradition of starting their meal on Thanksgiving Day, not with all the food on the table, but just with 5 kernels of corn. We've done this in my family sometimes. And everyone shares just 5 things that they're thankful for. It's a good reminder to us that God has given us a lot. But even when we don't have a lot, He's still blessing us and He's still with us. So let's remember that this Thanksgiving. When you have all that good food, there are many people who don't have enough food. And yet God is with them also. We want to find a way to share our blessings with those who don't have enough. When God blesses us, it's so that we can bless others. Let's pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you so much for the many blessings you've given us. I thank you now for these children, for their hard work and their beautiful voices and their memorization of your word. Lord, we thank you for the so many blessings.